Good Morning Bay Street is a production of theuptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit theuptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning. This is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Friday, January 23rd, 2009. In the pre-market this morning, we've got some selling across the board. The Dow futures on the screenshot are down 167. Looking over my shoulder, they're down 137. So we have come off our lows in the pre-market, but we're certainly going to see some selling at 930. Now, yesterday, after I did my presentation, I mentioned we're going to get some economic numbers. They came out. They weren't very good. We also got numbers from Microsoft, and not only did Microsoft make a new 52-week low, also made multi-year lows. Now, Microsoft's had a really ugly chart for the last month. The pros and the public have just been intertwined, telling us that these guys didn't know which way this stock was going to go. There was no commitment on either side. They were waiting for a breakout, and the breakout was to the downside. Now, Friday morning in the pre-market, General Electric announced the stock is actually up. Even though the numbers don't look very good, the stock was up 20, 30 cents last time I looked. So we're certainly not seeing selling pressure on Friday from General Electric. Seeing a lot of pressure from the financial sector. We've been keeping track of it using the ultra shorts for the U.S. financial sector. We've been certainly watching stocks like Citibank just to see what they would do at their November lows. A lot of stocks that have broken through the November lows, of course, of some of those international banks that people think are going to be nationalized. Here's an Irish bank. Here's a British bank, Barclays. All of these are just crumbling in the past few days. Here's the Royal Bank of Scotland. This stock was at $22 back in early December, and now it's down at three and change. One of the other areas that's showing significant weakness this week is the U.S. regional banks. There's a whole bunch of them that have just dropped 50-60% in the last few days. And these are not household names to most people, but they are for people in the financial sector, and just seeing them crumble one after another in the past couple of weeks. Now, one of the problems that we've got this week is if we close lower on Friday, we're going to see most of our weekly buy signals evaporate and turn into weekly sell signals. So we'll have to see how that turns out on Friday afternoon. For the TSX on Friday, looking at the daily charts, to get a new daily buy signal, we're going to need a daily close above 9,000. For the S&P 500, we're going to need a daily close above 870. For the NASDAQ, 1550, and for the SOX index, 217. We need a daily close above those numbers to give us new buy signals on Friday. And at the open, we certainly don't think we're going to see that. Take a look at our hourly breakpoints on Friday. For the TSX, we are on an hourly downtrend. We need an hourly close above 8610. For the S&P 500, we're holding an hourly uptrend. We need a close below 818 to give us a new sell signal. For the NASDAQ, similar situation. We need an hourly close below 1558. And I think based on the pre-market numbers, we're going to see that at 10:30 this morning. Looking at the VIX, we need an hourly close above 5075 to give us a new buy signal on the VIX index to confirm the down move in the rest of the U.S. markets. Looking at gold was up yesterday. It's up in the pre-market this morning. We're looking for some resistance at the 875-880 area. Next target to the upside would be 900, then 906. And that's ultimately where we think gold's going to fade. What we saw yesterday was even though gold was up, gold stocks were down. We expect to see that on Friday. Remember, the people who trade gold and the people who trade gold stocks are two completely different groups of people. Okay, that's all for Friday morning, folks. If we see a weak close on Friday, that would probably signal a bunch of weekly sell signals, and those investors that put long-term money back in the market would probably want to exit the market at that time. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again over the weekend.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.